All right, everyone, welcome to Let's Play Black Closet. So, I have played through like the first month or so of the game. We'll be starting, of course, a new game with a slightly higher difficulty. I was playing it on easy before. I'm going to try for normal because easy seemed exceptionally easy for me. And I would like a little bit of a challenge. I like strategy games and I like to have a little bit of a challenge when I'm playing it. I do have a fan in my window because it's really hot where I am right now. And you may hear some other people in my house in the background. I apologize for that. There's nothing I can really do about it. Kind of have a loud family. It's just the way it is. So without further ado, let's start the game. It looks like you've seen the tutorial before, if you wish to. Okay, so we're not going to skip it because I want you guys to see the introduction. Welcome to your new office, Elsa, and congratulations. As student council president, everything here belongs to you, for now. It's an honor and a privilege. I hope you'll remember that in the weeks ahead. The privilege of your position... The privileges of your position come with a great deal of responsibility. It is your duty to manage the student body and prevent scandals while maintaining their belief in your good nature. If you are too aggressive, then the karma of the student council will be damaged and your classmates will no longer obey you. If you let them get away with everything, then the reputation of the school will be damaged. I look forward to the challenge. Cocky, aren't you? I hope your strengths hold up to what's ahead. No nice words here, Elsa. This school is in peril. We have enemies who would like nothing more than to smash this ivory tower to rubble. And scandal is their greatest weapon. If St. Claudine's falls, every graduate, every board member, every good traditional family will be tarnished. The school board will do whatever they must to defend themselves. As student council president, you are their designated scapegoat. Your family background, you are not old power. You are a talented upstart, nothing more. If disaster looms, you are the perfect sacrifice for the greater good. So they'll expel me to save themselves? You will take the blame for every failure this school has ever faced, unless you succeed. If you do your job and defend this school, there will be no need for a sacrifice. Fail as president and you will be expelled, unable to achieve a place in a decent university. Your future will be ruined before it even begins. But keep things running smoothly and your time at St. Claudine's will be a benefit to your resume. Of course, you will have the rest of the student council to assist you. A commander never gets her own hands dirty. You will need to rely on the skills of your minions to handle your caseload and find the truth behind the rumors. Read your case files to determine targets, then set out assignments for your minions to take actions, where they will match their skills against the skills of the target. Let's look at an example. Now this I don't need to see, but now it's not going to let me skip. Alright, sorry I didn't read that part. So click on Jessica as the target, but, sorry there. So, Jessica's the new target, you haven't learned skills, blah blah blah, and then we have to question. And then we choose the person that's going to question her, and assign. And then we click the done button. It's just, I'm gonna just kind of blow through this because I already know how the basic mechanics of the game work. Jessica says, is there anything you need? You may now harass Jessica. So now we click this, and then we choose harass, and then we choose her, and then we choose assign, and done. So basically, this is the kind of thing, we're just kind of skimming over this part because it has absolutely no reflection on the story at all. It's strictly a tutorial. If the skill of the minions you assign is not sufficient to conquer the target, you may get incomplete or misleading reports and need to try again. Check your case log to review the clues you have gathered. Now for your final instructions. It is important that we are not disturbed. Assign some students to stand guard over this location. You can assign... Okay, so We click this, and then we click both of these guys to guard, and then assign. Doesn't matter. Now let us speak clearly. You are the leader here, but you are helpless without the skills of your minions, and that creates a weakness which someone intends to exploit. One of your minions is a traitor. Which one? We don't know. One of them is working against you and will intentionally fail her assignments whenever possible in the hopes of causing scandal and bringing down the school. You must determine which of your minions cannot be trusted or she will destroy you. Spend time with them, socialize, do whatever you must. Manage your karma, defend the school's reputation, and identify the traitor or else your career will come to a quick end. Good luck, Madam President. She leaves the office, your office, a symbol of your power and the expectations others will have placed on you. Will you live up to those expectations or surprise them all? When you reach the student council office, Vaughn is already waiting for you. Ah, there you are, Elsa. Everything is in order. One of the chairs had a rip in the cushion, so I had maintenance swap it out. All the filing slots are clean, and there's a fresh box of pushpins by the bulletin board. I really like Vaughn. Vaughn is my favorite of, like, the month that I played, Vaughn was my favorite. So you didn't have to do all that. I intend to do my job well. Being vice president means more than just waiting for a chance to step into your shoes, Captain. Why are you calling me Captain? You don't remember? Captain rolls off the tongue more easily than Madam President, don't you think? There's a sound at the door. That must be the other officers. To tell Elsa that she has to... Oh, you're already here. And what were you going to tell our President? Well, I don't mean to be rude, Vaughn. But all things considered, it's not right that you are vice president when my big sister is so much more qualified. I don't want the job. You didn't want to be president, that's fine, but you deserve. I'm not... How do you pronounce this? Thace? Thice? Thais? I have no idea. We're calling her Teresa because I don't know how to pronounce this. I'm not interested. You're a natural leader, and she has the personality of a secretary. Vaughn was elected, end of story. Oh, fine. Be stuck in your duty, in your dusty old ways. Youth will overcome, and you'll see. The door opens again. Hello? Is this the student council room? Yes, this is the student council. Oh, good. I found the right place. I'm Mallory. I'm the hospitality officer. Oh, right. New girl. Be respectful to this young... Oh, sorry. Be respectful to this young lady. It's your first year... Sorry. Be respectful to this young lady. It's your first year on student council, too. Yes, but I've been at this school since kindergarten, and she's just started as a freshman. Well, I think it's lovely to see some new faces. Thanks? It's a pleasure to meet you, Mallory. It's nice to meet you, too. I look forward to working with all of you. Aren't we missing someone? What about Rowan? She's already here. Rowan is another favorite of mine. I really like Rowan. Well, if we're all here, let's get started. Now that your minions are assembled, it is time to open your case folders and see what this week has in store. So, failing to solve the major cases Miss Talmadge assigns, such as finding the traitor, will lead to a game over. Okay, so let's begin our week. Case 1. The bespoke corset belonging to Alma has vanished. Locate and return the corset. Alma last remembers seeing it in either her room or the cafeteria. Also, both Phoebe and Jesse were admiring it recently. So, we have Alma, Jesse, Phoebe, and then we have to search the cafeteria and Alma's room. And then going to the supply closet will provide us with items that will increase our chances of successfully handling these later. So, when do I need to have this solved by is the question. this doesn't have, like, a distinct ending date the way... So these cases appear to be randomized because I had a completely different case when I started my last game. So we're just going to kind of get a feel. So we just want to question her, and it doesn't have to be something, like, super big since she is the victim. Okay, so wait. This is not working. Okay, so question and then assign. There we go. And then we'll need someone to be fairly observant for this. So we'll send Vaughn to inspect here, and then we'll send Rowan to inspect Alma's room. And then Teresa will question Phoebe with Althea questioning Jesse. And we're just going to kind of hope for the best in this situation. So, observation and social, chance of 17. Yay, success. Okay. Alma says, I remember Jesse asking me about my corset. So, and then Vaughn. Ah, shit. Okay. You don't find anything. That doesn't mean anything isn't in the room. It just means that we didn't get it. Too close to call. Damn it. Okay. Failure. Okay. I don't even know what you're talking about, so we'll have to revisit Phoebe as well. Success, though, with Jesse. Alma's corset? Yeah, it was really a nice one, wasn't it? This is suspicious. You may now search Jesse's room. But we couldn't find it in Alma's room or the cafeteria. We didn't get any success with either of those, and now their stress levels are higher, so we'll have to be a bit more careful. So, what we're going to do is assign these two to the cafeteria, these two to Alma's room, and for some reason that is giving... Okay, let's go this. Why is the win ratio so low? Well, whatever, we can just try. And then we'll assign Rowan to question Phoebe. What about harass? Stock has 100%, so we'll do that and hope for the best. God damn it! You don't find anything. This one's probably gonna say too close to call, too. You don't find anything. Well, I guess we'll just have to go through Jesse's room. Success. Phoebe doesn't seem to notice you following her, but you don't learn anything new. Okay. Oh, delivery. What's in the box? She adjusts its position in her arms. One bag organic gold Colombian coffee. One classic style French press, silver monogrammed. Tea set, gold trim. I didn't order these. I was told to deliver them to you. Okay, thank you. You're welcome. Okay, so everyone's stress is coming up. So I think what we're going to do is go into Jesse's room, do, 100%. Do I have to send everyone in? Why are these so... Oh my god, this is, like, a serious, jump. In difficulty compared to my last one. So we'll just send these guys to search, even though it doesn't look like my chance of being successful there is terrible. Get supplies, because I'm going to need them. You were caught. God damn it! You find the corset, though! Yes! Okay, so we now know it was Jesse. And, wow, we get a sedative. What the fuck? Althea was waiting for me in my office in my chair. Afternoon, Elsa. Can I help you? Could be so. This is our senior year. We're almost out of this place looking forward to it. There's a lot of hard work between now and graduation. For you, not for me. I've served my time. I'm just waiting for my ride. If you give me these fiddly little detailed jobs, well, I can't guarantee I'll tick all the boxes. I'll try to give you better assignments. That's a good girl? Fuck you, bitch. You'll see, it's much easier this way. Nice talking to you, Elsa. Let's do it again sometime. So you're getting the boring shit, lady. Now that she's made her point, there's business at hand. Okay. So, we need to put her in detention, and then we'll... Okay, good. That gives us 100% win rate. So we'll go here. And then... we'll have her go and get some stuff from the supply closet and then give Althea nothing because she doesn't fucking deserve it. Success. Izzy cracks under pressure and swears never to steal again. Yas. Solved. Yas. Yas. Okay, so the first time I did this, I did not know you had to get a confession in order for it to be solved. I thought because we found the item in the person's room, that was enough and we could just expel them and it was fine, but that's not how it works. So, yas. Fashion tips. Remember to try the supply closet, find fashion advice. Vaughn is absent due to stress, Mallory is absent due to stress, Rowan is absent due to stress, which is fine. Teresa has requested a private meeting. We are getting a lot more meetings here than I did in my last one, like it was hardly anything happening. Oh good, you're here. Sit down, make yourself comfortable. This won't take long. I just thought I should point out that I'm not a servant. My birthday parties have been detailed in the society pages since I was 13. My calling cards were engraved and registered within a week of my birth. So, fetching supplies, it's beneath me. Well, you don't hear... I did hear her sister complaining, though. So, they do apparently complain if you give them a task they don't like. This is bullshit. You're a freshman. Nothing's beneath you. I'm aware that you have seniority and that despite your family, you have been appointed president and I have to follow your commands. I am simply pointing out that you are wasting my talents and I won't stand quietly by. Which talents would those be? I can be very persuasive when people are stubborn and afraid. Wait. Are you saying I don't have any talents? Is that what you're saying? No, of course not. It's good to know, though, that she has an idea of what her strengths are, but I also know what her weaknesses are. Like, she can't stalk, and she's not one for searching rooms, so that's why you got sent to the supply closet. See that you do better in the future, and we won't have to have this conversation again. Ta! Now that she's made her point, there's business at hand. Okay. So we have to training room, and since they're on break, I actually like Teresa. I don't like Althea so much, but, I would like to see, but here's the thing. I think out of everyone, they are most likely to betray me, since we do have a traitor in our midst. So, I don't know if I want to train them up when they're going to betray me. So... y'all are going to the supply closet again! Oh, too many girls for the supply closet. Okay. Well, Althea is the weaker, and she pissed me off. So. Wait, what? Return to game. Done. There we go. And now we have jewelry. On the weekend, you can now visit your minions to shore up their loyalty. Great! So. I'm pretty confident about Vaughn and Rowan. Everyone's loyalty is at 20. So, I like Vaughn most, but I'd also like to get a feel for Teresa. We'll visit Vaughn first. Hi, Elsa. Did you need something? Let's keep it casual. I'd like to invite you to tea. Oh, alright. Thank you. That sounds lovely. Vaughn follows you to your office, looking back and forth as she enters. I wasn't sure if anyone else would be here. Have a seat, I'll pour you tea. Really, I can take care of that. You should sit, I'll prepare the tea. You are my guest, and you are my captain. I am your subordinate. It's my job to make your life run smoothly so that you can focus on business without having to worry about the details. Today isn't about business. I thought since we were here, my apologies. If this isn't official business, then I defer to you as hostess. Why is that happening? Tea would be lovely, thank you. You prepare the drinks and set out the gold-rimmed teacups. I remember offering her something, but I don't think she liked frosted. She seems kind of like a cucumber sandwich girl. Thank you, they're very nice. Got it right! Yes. Okay. Sips her cup and smiles at you. So here we are. It's nice to have a chance to sit and relax between crises. But there's something on your mind, isn't there? Is everything all right? Me? Is that what this is about? Have I seemed unhappy to you? Let's go worried. You seem worried sometimes, do I? I suppose I have a few things on my mind. After all, I have a lot to live up to if I'm going to follow in your shoes. Vaughn rests her fingers on the edge of the table. This is a strange tea party, isn't it? I suppose we should talk about hats or hairdressing or politics, all similarly frivolous. Alright, then let's ask what's your favorite color? Periwinkle blue. It's a pretty word, it's nice to say, and a pretty flower too. What about you? I like gray. Mysterious or symbolic? She sets down her teacup. I really should go, I need to study. Thank you for your time and the tea. Thank you for coming. Increases by 5! Yas! Okay, so we get a second one, and this time I'm going to go for Teresa to kind of get a feel. Oh, Elsa, what do you want? I don't have enough evidence, really, to suggest that she is purposely failing or anything, so we're going to wait. Let's just invite her to tea. Oh, well, alright then. Lead the way to the office and hold the door for Teresa as she enters. So, oh wow, you can really hear a dog outside. Sorry about that. So, let's go tea or coffee. Are we allowed coffee now? I thought that was against the rules. It's presidential privilege. I suppose I may as well try a cup if you're offering. You prepare the drinks and set out the gold-rimmed teacups. So, we're going to offer her the pink frosted cakes. Oh, those look nice. I mean, they look better in blue or purple with spiral trim and some sugar work or edible glitter. But this will do. Kind of a bitch. Okay, sips delicately from her cup and settles it back in its saucer. So, was there something you wanted to talk to me about? This isn't about my sister, is it? Is there something I should know about, Althea? I wouldn't think so. You've known her long enough. I'm just saying I'm not carrying love letters for you. Does that happen to you often? People asking? Yes. Me actually doing it? No. Well, the girls in my class know better than to ask me that anymore after what I did to Megan. I won't have these unworthy girls wasting my sister's time. So forget about it. That's not why I asked you here. So what did you want then? I want to talk about you. Oh, alright. What did you want to know? Let's just kind of gather the general favorite colors. All of them. Oh, okay. You can't separate one color from another. You need the whole palette to create an ensemble. That's what the word means, together. Twist her cup around it in its saucer. So, I still don't understand why I'm here. What do you want from me? Do you want a makeover or something? Are you saying I need one? No offense, but whether you're trying to fit in or stand out, there's a lot more you could do with yourself. Well, you know where to find me when you're ready. I should be going. Ta! And her loyalty increased by 5. So that's good. Alright. If an action uses only one skill, there's not much point in assigning two minions. Only the highest skill present will be used. Added more minions does not provide bonus. Okay. Unusual number of students have been missing class due to illness, and they don't seem to be faking. Investigate. Linda and Anita came to class recently with suspiciously similar injuries. Have they been fighting? Mallory has requested a private meeting. Hi. Thank you for seeing me. I'm always happy to talk with my officers. Of course you are, because you're good and you're the president and the student council does good things, right? We act for the greater good. This isn't what I was expecting. I thought it was really nice of everybody to make me their representative when I'd only just started at this school. I was looking forward to helping people, not to being a bully. We are harsh for them for their own good. Well, yes, but, I mean, sometimes... I'm sorry, I'm overreacting. I just never imagined myself on the side of people giving out discipline. It's like being a parent, isn't it? I promise I'll do my best. So we're learning that Teresa and Althea, don't like doing the running around shit. And now Mallory is not one for confrontation. Now that she's made her point, there's business. Okay. So... let's see. Oh, okay, so these are two separate usual numbers. So this is just two. Okay. All right. And then we'll question. And then I think because we need some social, and her social sucks. Actually, whoa. Someone has leftover fireworks. Okay, so wait. We're not going to assign you. We're going to assign Mallory because we're just questioning them. It shouldn't be too bad for her. I'll just do fashion tips just to give a little oomph. And then Althea would be another good social person. And then we'll assign stock, and then question. And then, sorry, Teresa, have you get from this supply closet? And then we'll have you harass, because that is... then we'll just go ahead and add that for good measure. And hopefully this hasn't been all, a huge mistake. Whoa, okay. God damn it. I'm sorry, I can't remember what I ate yesterday. I missed my history class today. You may now search the history classroom. Okay. Success. And he says, the last thing I ate before I fell ill was fish and chips, and then I had to miss my history class. You may now search the cafeteria. So we'll look at the cafeteria, I think. Okay, Belinda doesn't seem to notice you following her around, but you don't learn anything new, okay? And then we got a lemon, which gives us minus everything, so why would we want it? Success. Anita says, okay, Belinda and I had a fight, but I apologize and it's all over now, okay? It's done. Looks like the mystery is solved. Oh, cool. Yas! Vaughn has arrived. So she's gonna complain that I sent her to the supply closet. Captain, there's some paperwork for you need to fill out. What's this about? Something to do with updating your school medical insurance. Apparently, the student council president, as the student council president, you're entitled to a higher tier at no extra charge, the prerequisites of power. Or actually, that may not have been what that word was. Oh well. I do it myself, but it asks for your personal information, parents' address, birthday, all that. Thank you, Lieutenant. You're welcome. Oh, look at her smile! If you finish it quickly, I can have it delivered and returned in time for today's assignments. So, I'll see you then. Okay. So, we finished that. So, now what we're going to do is we're going to go to the cafeteria. Oh, everyone's getting higher on stress. I don't like that. We'll send you, and we'll send Mallory to search. What if we send Rowan? What if we just send everyone? Okay, so let's see, we need stealth. But she's not the one for that. And observe. Alright, this looks like it's gonna be our best option. And what is... This item gives you bonus of plus 10 to any action that targets. Okay, so we're not gonna... Why does that keep happening? That didn't happen at all last time. So, oops, we'll just assign those two with that. I'll send her to search, but I don't really expect her to find anything. And then we'll send Fawn to the training room. And then Althea goes to the supply closet, even though she doesn't like it, but too fucking bad. Too close to call. Students wonder why you're poking around the cafeteria. Council loses one karma. You don't find anything. And that was a success. So. Failure. Students wonder why you're poking around. This is one karma. Success. According to teacher's notebook, there was a history test on the day that Jocelyn and Laylee were out sick. Okay, so skill training. So, she's very good with observation, so I think what we want to do is build up her stealth. Build up her social, and then build up in... Do I want her to be intimidating? I think I'm going to keep her off the intimidating track. I like the idea that she can be observant and... We'll actually make her observant and social, I think. We got crystal ball. He's absent due to Melody's absent due to stress. Okay, so we have three out due to stress. But that's okay. So, because of that, okay, what if we do this? Nope, chances of winning on that one are worse. Alright, so let's go ahead and go after Lily like that. Then Althea was under stress just from going to the supply closet, so I guess we'll just leave Vaughn alone. Success, excellent. Yes, I did miss history test because of it, but you can't prove I did it on purpose. May now search Lily's room. Excellent. And now everyone's back. So, we're gonna need high stealth. Okay, does that help? No. Unknown odds. So I guess we'll just have to deal. And then They're going to harass. That doesn't help. Well, we'll just try it and see how far it gets us. Too close to call, your car ran. Shit! Too close to call, you don't find anything, so I'll have to repeat that. Too close to call says it's not my fault, I got sick. Cancel it! God damn it! I lost 10 karma! Shit, this isn't looking good. Alright. Okay. So, new tactic. Harass. That has 100% win. And then cafeteria. We're searching. So we have win on observation, but it would be too close to call for stealth. Okay. That's okay. We'll wait one more turn and then just have Mallory go to the supply closet. Success. Jessen says, yes, I did miss. Okay, so she says the exact same thing. Okay, shit. It's the weekend. Am I gonna fail that? Okay. So, do we have anyone that is, like, repeated? Oddly enough, it looks like Vaughn is messing up. But let's visit Althea. Hello, are you looking for me? I've come to invite you to tea. Why, Elsa, is this a date? I suppose you could call it that. Now I'm intrigued. Very well, lead the way. Althea follows you into the office, then holds the door for you as you enter. So here we are. Tea or coffee? Either is fine. No, wait. I'll have the coffee. Isn't the president's private stock? It's the president's private stock, isn't it? Milk, no sugar. You prepare the drinks and set out the gold-rimmed teacups, and then let's give her shortbread. What's this? Interesting, I suppose I'll try some. What do you want to see me about? Want to get to know you better. We've known each other for, what, 14 years? How long we've both been residents of this fine establishment. You've even been to my house, even if it was back in lower school. I know you exist, that doesn't mean I know you well. So what do you want to know? We're gonna go with favorite colors, always. Red, and I like sports cars, pandas, and women in uniform. Are you writing a dating profile? Althea takes a slow sip, holding her cup to her lips for a moment afterward to forestall conversation. You're a very pleasant hostess, but unless there's something specific you need, I should get going. Thank you for coming. Have a good day. Then we'll visit Rowan. Yes? Come to invite you to tea. All right. I'm just waiting for you to speak. She's not saying anything. Tea or coffee? Students aren't allowed coffee except for the president's student council. Yes, but do you want coffee? Fine, I'll choose you if that's what you want. You prepare the drinks and set out the gold-rimmed teacups. Give cheese and crackers. Thank you. Arranges food neatly on her saucer, but makes no move to eat it. Silence. So tell me about yourself. I like what? What's your favorite color? Orange? Orange is a nice color. Yes. You notice that Rowan's snack has disappeared, although you can't remember ever seeing her take a bite. Do you enjoy being on the student council? Do you? It's exciting. Because you are the president. Moments pass and becomes clear Rowan isn't going to say anything else. Thank you for your time. You're welcome. Well, she seemed happy at least. Safe action. Never lose time. It's a good way. Okay. These four Tessines are of an aristocrat in the is in danger of failing her Russian class. This must be prevented. Strange moaning sounds coming from the auditorium at night, and rumors suggest it may be haunted. Investigate. Wonderful. And I'm down 2 due to stress. That's great! Which means I only have Vaughn. Oh, and now I can search. Excellent. We'll assign those 2. Quietly search Jocelyn's room. Don't find anything. So we'll have to... Okay, so now everyone's back. And we'll go ahead... Have you questioned them. And then for this 2, we will send these 2 out again. What if we add? Nope. Alright, so no matter what, we might end up taking a hit. Which sucks. Then send you 2 guard, and then you're going to the supply closet whether you like it or not. Oh shit, I forgot. Oh man, I messed that up. Let's see. She sighs, I study, but I never get anywhere. As long as I can pass the... Shit! We find a receipt for a purchase of sedatives from Annie. This is suspicious. You may now detain Lily. You may now search Annie's room. Same guard at the auditorium. Success. Nothing happens. Okay. Okay. So now we can detain. So that one's good. And then we can this one's gonna be the best for detaining. And then Annie's room. God, I really wish I had better. This has to be stealth. So, let's try searching this. We can just assign Rowan to that. I hate how much my karma is dropping. It pisses me off. Then let's we have search or stakeout. So for this one we need observation and stealth. We'll assign both of them to that, I think. Cracks under pressure and promises to make herself sick to avoid his skin. Dames. She is no longer a target in this case. Success. Cracks under pressure and gives up a stash of stolen sedatives. Ugh. It was a D rating. That's great. Too close to call. That's success. According to the teacher's notes, the best student in the class is Taja. Maybe she could tutor Jocelyn. You may now persuade or harass Taja. Success. You hide and wait, but nothing happens. discovering the auditorium. This must be the source of the noise, not the carry at all. Ah, damn. But I still gained a training point. Okay, so I'm down to only one case. Unfortunately, I messed up that last one, but that's okay. So we have this. She is going to be the most... Let's try her just by herself. And then for... Okay, and then that's a pretty good... Okay, so let's try that. Success. Okay, I'll offer to study with Jessine. Quietly search her room. You find a set of old Russian notes. They look well used. Tasha's help should be able to improve her grades. Yas. One is now absent due to stress. It has arrived. Ooh, at my office for me. Shit. Good afternoon, Elsa. I hope your regular investigations are progressing well. However, that's not why I'm here. Now that you've had some time to mingle with the girls and watch their behavior, do you have any leads as to who the traitor might be? It's too soon to be certain, of course, but perhaps you might have identified a prime suspect. No one stands out. Really? I do hope that's a sign of you being cautious and not one of undeserved loyalty. No one has seemed to, like, overly fuck up their assignments, so it's hard for me to tell. Don't be misled, Elsa. One of those girls is lying to you, and... she will make you pay the cost for her deception. Whatever the case, time is not on your side. The traitor must be exposed and expelled before the Harvest Festival. Okay. That means on October 24th, you must be prepared to deliver the final verdict. You cannot investigate each student equally. Focus your attention on those who seem most suspicious. Build their loyalty, learn their secrets. The school board is counting on you to make the right decision. I'll leave you to your work. Okay, so I think we are well past the time that I typically give one part. We'll just say that this is the opening part, and it was extra long, possibly. Thank you for watching, and I will see you next time.